Yes, ma'am.
If you're over 65 and you have not had hormone therapy previously, from 65 on, can't you at least hold where you are for the most part?
Yes. You can prevent further deterioration of your bones, but you probably is going to be very hard for hormones to give you a new bone. But if you can preserve what you have, also I recommend if you're over 60 already, get a DEXA scan first. DEXA scan is the best test that calculate the density of your bones. And it's a computerized mathematical formula which calculates differentially your hip, your wrist, your spine, and see which one is vulnerable for fracture. And also, yeah, go ahead.
If the hormones are, I mean, yeah, when you're younger, it's great to help with the osteoporosis and all that. But for older people, if the hormones help so much with your mental state and all of that, wouldn't that, even if it's not going to help with the osteo?
Like I said, I give it up to 75. I offer it up to 75. Is there any science to me saying, well, you shouldn't get it after 75? There is no science. I have two or three patients who are above 75. I have an 80-year-old also gets hormones. I usually don't encourage it. There's nothing in the textbook as a guideline or any research that I have that I can go by. So it's just like, to answer your question, there is no clear guideline on that how long you use the hormones. What I normally say is that use it for 5 years. If you are already in 70s, use it for 2 or 3 years. Use it less. Again, there is no guidelines. One might ask, why not use, you know, stay younger? Why not use it for 20 years or 25 years? Start at the age of 45 and use it until 70. Maybe that's a good idea. I really have nothing against it, but I just tell you that some things we don't know. I don't have the answer. Yes.
Can you get any of those answers by retesting on, let's say, a 3, 6, 12-month basis? If you can find out markers by testing, if someone needs hormones initially, if they were retested every 6 months to a year.
That's actually precisely what I do. I do limited blood test every 6 months, and then I do a full test every year. And the reason they are still in therapy, older people, is because I'm not testing them just for hormones. I replace hormones. I test to see where was their cholesterol and where is it now. Where was their other liver function before and where is it now? Where was their, when they came in, their vitamin D was abysmally low. Now it is over here. We need to keep giving them supplementation. So the patients that are in my office, they are not in the hormonal therapy. We call it anti-aging because I'm taking care of your medical problems at the same time and reducing the risk of other problems. Now remember, hormones are going to bring your cholesterol down, for example. But if your cholesterol was very high to begin with, they may not knock it down that much. So we may have to do something else. I can tell you there are therapies available that are just too good to be true. There is no cost to you. Through natural therapy, you can knock down your cholesterol without having to take that drug that costs you $6,000 a year that every primary care doctor gave you.
I have a question. A 65-year-old male, would he be a candidate for this therapy if he has a mechanical valve?
I have to look into that. I will not give it to him without doing some research first. But he may be able to do many other things. Is he overweight?
No.
Okay. He can be tested for a lot of other things in terms of risk of heart disease. If everything else looks wonderful,
it does.
Maybe he's a candidate.
Okay.
Then maybe if everything else is good. Otherwise, he's healthy.
I'm 77.
You look 67, by the way.
I feel 57.
See, one of the things, I think this is one of the best things that you have done for yourself. Yes.
But I take testosterone, and I've taken it over the last year or so. I feel great. My mental attitude's improved. My physical well-being has improved. I don't have all those things you talk about, cholesterol. I don't have any of that. I went for the bone scan. I have no bone loss. I just think it's wonderful at any age, but you got to exercise and you got to eat right.
Thank you.
I just want to say one other thing. They just came out with a study on calcium supplements. They can cause heart attacks. This just came out in the last couple of days. They're now recommending that you get your calcium through food, not through those 750 milligram things that they recommend. I just want to.
Right. Here is how I heard about that study. This is how science works, is when a study comes out, you heard it on TV or radio?
I got it off the computer.
Okay. When a study comes out, there's a process to scientific research, which means the study is done and it reached a conclusion. Now that study has to be duplicated and verified multiple times by several researchers in different locations, those who are not connected with each other.
Yeah.
In other words, there is no bias, there is no company trying to sell something. And if multiple studies prove a point, then it becomes what is called the standard of care. And the protocols change from the top level. The specialty groups, there are, for example, OBGYNs have American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists. They will change the standard, and that compendium every year is sent to all the OBGYNs all over the country. Urology Association, they will do the same thing, the organizations. So first of all, I do not give people heavy doses of calcium. Here is the bottom line, let me give you. There are very few supplements and nutrients which have been scientifically proven to help you. One of the biggest problems in the alternative healthcare industry is that because there is no regulation, you know, considering we disregard all the evils of the traditional medicine and the drug companies and the FDA and profit making, and they want to give you more and more drugs, disregard that for a minute. The alternative healthcare industry has a bigger problem. Because of there's no regulation, therefore everybody's promoting everything and claiming that there's a clinical studies show. You saw many advertisements you see on TV. Everybody has a clinical study. That's not science. You may be a company that make a product, and the clinical studies that you are referring to is your own clinical studies that you did in your backyard. Those, just like those who sell vitamins, they grind it in their backyard and say the best product, they will convince you somehow. So it's extremely important that although alternative medicine is wonderful, you have to be careful what you do because nobody is really watching over. I'm not saying government is an angel, but at least when you have the FDA control, there is some check and balances. But if there's no check and balances, then you have no idea what's going on.
There's no checks and balances over bioidentical hormones. FDA isn't involved. Nobody's involved.
FDA,
it's the Wild West out there.
FDA, I will be happy to give you an article. FDA has been investigating a lot of pharmacies for making those claims. So the FDA is doing a lot. There is.
But they're not. It's an unregulated industry.
For the most part, it is. That is why FDA is investigating some pharmacies that claim that they are selling bioidentical hormones. And I agree with you, that's a problem. In alternative healthcare industry, you have to be very careful. You should always be involved in doing your own research. Know what you're getting, ask questions, see what sources this stuff comes from, who's giving me what. Remember when I started the lecture, I said to you, ask 4 out of 5 people or doctors who practice bioidentical hormones and the pharmacies who supply them. What is bioidentical hormone? And all of a sudden, they don't know what to say. They don't know. If you cannot define something, how are you selling it? So FDA is going from time, place to place, and there have been a lot of investigations going on. But also remember the way legal system is. It's very hard to sue people because the legal system in the United States is probably worse than the practice of medicine. That is total abuse. It's complete. The judges, the lawyers, the courts, they will wipe you out, and they will not tell you until the last minute when you're ready to lose your house, lose your family, lose everything. Then they will tell you the truth, that you shouldn't have sued in the first place. They will keep it quiet and give you a lot of encouragement. They will say, yes, you have a good case. You should sue. Yeah, go after it. This is, you have evidence. But they will tell you after you lost your house, you lost everything. So what happens is, that is true for government, that's true for Wall Street, that is true for industries and corporations. The only people who benefit from suing each other is this company is suing this company for $100 million. That they are professionals. They know that if they win, that there will be a settlement. The legal system in the United States is not designed for average people. And the economic financial infrastructure in the United States is the 91% of the population lives in total luxury. The other 4-5% live pretty comfortably. And the other 90% of the population eats dirt for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That is how capitalism, as wonderful it was, Adam Smith warned in his book, just like Karl Marx pointed out, some of the problems that might emerge with communism. Adam Smith, the father of capitalism, he said, be careful. There is going to be some problems because the human nature, when human nature comes in as a factor, you are going to have people exploiting other people. And the capitalism that we adopted, it was extreme in the sense that there was no control. In other words, you can engage in false advertisement. You can sell whatever you want. You can lie. Whatever you want to do, you can do that. And that's what, it's all legal. Very difficult to sue you. So I agree with you. That's why I pointed out, be careful, because there is not much regulation in the alternative healthcare industry. But let's move on. So how long you use hormones, it's up to you. I recommend 5 years. Yes, ma'am.
I just have a question. What scientific or university study recognize these therapies?